how many of students have gone through the historical background of endocrinology?
एक बार बस रेड किया था सर.
चलो रेड किया, कितने, जस्ट रेज योर हैंड, आप अपना हाथ ऊपर करके बता दीजिए जिन्होंने पढ़ा है. But well, the basic purpose of going through the historical background is we should get to know about the subject. So well, you have all the notes. I'll not go through that again. Very quickly, I'll just take few points of the history of the endocrinology. Thereafter, I'll move to the endocrinology proper. Is visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. As you can see that the history of endocrinology goes back to 460 to 322 BC, when Hippocrates and Aristotle indicated that there might be some internal control over the functions of the body. And in fact, Aristotle described in his writings that the castration in the birds and human beings brings out some changes in those persons, but that could not be proved, could not be well understood at that time. Considering this fact, though endocrinology is the writings about the endocrinology goes back to times of Aristotle and Hippocrates, but at the same time is a very new subject, very new latest subject, I think topic. Not much work had been done on this earlier. And in 1920, who was the first to coin the word hormone?
Starling.
Yeah, Bayliss and Starling were the first scientists to given a term for the duodenal secretions to a hormone, which was at that time referred it as secretin. So when the acidic secretions reaches the duodenum, comes out of that, and such secretions were referred as hormones. Okay, I'm getting some disturbance, a lot of disturbance. Rohit, Anupriya, aap na mute kar lijiye.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and whenever you want to speak, you can just unmute it and speak out, and then I'll respond it. No issue. There are a few more important things that happened in the regarding this endocrinology historical background. That from time to time, insulin, they get to know about the insulin, and thereafter they found out its structure. Then and so many scientists got Nobel Prize in this field. So you can just go through those notes. I'll quickly, I'll not focusing much on that. I'd like to focus on endocrinology specific today, because since this is a starting lecture, one thing more, that I have just hardly 8 to 10 slides today, because I like to devote more time on these slides, because these are the lectures. I think I had indicated you earlier also that these are the basic topics of endocrinology, which needs to be dealt at very thoroughly. You must, you can stop me wherever required, where you want to be revisited any topic. If instead of 8 or 10, I take up only 4 or 5 slides, no issue. But these are very important topics to be understood. So we start with first, what is endocrinology? Anybody who can take up this question? While teaching the different branches of endocrinology, I had told you what is endocrinology. Mosmi, you can define endocrinology.
It is a branch of science which deals with the study of endocrine system and their secretions and the diseases.
diseases. Sorry, anyway, that's still much better. Well, endocrinology is the branch of science which deals with the study of ductless glands and their secretions. Okay, so that is the basic definition. That further you can extrapolate, but we must talk of that it deals with the secretions of ductless glands. In our body, some of the glands are ducted, some are ductless. But in endocrinology, we deal with the mostly with the ductless gland, study of ductless. There is one and only one gland in the body which has ducted portion as well as ductless. Can anybody answer?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Fine. Pancreas. Chalia, that's good. So you know little bit about the endocrinology. Pancreas is the only gland which has ducted as well as ductless portion. Few more important things about the history before I move further. As I told you that Baylis and Starling were the first to coin the word. They were the first to coin the word hormone for duodenal secretions. Thereafter, in 1920-30, all steroid hormones were discovered. Between 1940 to 1950, a radioimmunoassay, then culture technique, electron microscopy, so many things were discovered. And in early 1921, insulin was isolated by the Banting and Best. So you can say 120 years hardly, we are ahead when the endocrinology teaching was started, whereas rest of other subjects are much, much ahead of this subject. So coming to the next slide. Well, we are going to deal with some of the important terminologies. Like first is, what is a hormone? When we are talking of endocrinology, what do we mean by hormone? Well, here you can see hormone is a Greek word which means to stimulate, and it was first coined, we just studied. So hormone means to stimulate, but how you will define hormone? Anyone?
Sir, hormone is a non-nutritive substance which is secreted in a small quantity.
Hormone is a
non-nutrient substance.
Okay. Well, in your way, it's fine. I think complete slide is visible to you, no? I'm getting hidden half partially.
Yes, sir.
आप पूरा पढ़ रहे हैं ना?
Yes, the entire slide is visible.
Right. So, hormone. First of all, there are two, three things to be remembered, then you can define hormone. First of all, hormone is a secretion of endocrine gland. Okay, so it is a chemical substance created by endocrine gland. Then it is transported through circulation in the body, and it has a definite target site where it acts. Got it? Three important things. Source of the hormone is, yes,
gland,
endocrine gland. Then it diffuses or it is transported through circulation, and it has a it acts on the specific site. So we define like this: a hormone is a chemical substance produced by endocrine gland, and it diffuses into the circulation, diffuses and transported to another area through circulation, where it influences the activity at target site. So, one thing more, hormone has a specific site of production. Specific site means our endocrine gland. Then it circulates in the body through blood circulation, and it acts on specific target site. It's not that it will act at any place. Okay, so one thing more to be, you can just go taking down agar koi aapko important lagta hai toh, it has a specific site of production and specific site of action. Clear? You can even record the lecture if you feel like. There is a recording button at the bottom, or आपको उसको रिविजिट कर सकते हैं लेटर ऑन. सो दैट इज द एग्जैक्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ हार्मोन. आई वंस अगेन रिपीट, हार्मोन इज ए केमिकल सब्सटेंस प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड्स, ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी थ्रू सर्कुलेशन एंड इट एक्ट्स एट स्पेसिफिक टारगेट साइट. क्लियर? या एनीबॉडी any doubt about the definition of hormone? किसी को कोई doubt है अगर?
No, sir. Fine.
We come to the next is neurohormones. Well, before coming to the neurohormones, I think you must have heard of pituitary gland. सुना है पहले?
Yes, sir.
What is the other name of pituitary gland?
Master glands.
No. Anybody else? Chippy कहाँ है ये? इसको बोलो वीडियो ऑन करे अपना. पीयूष, can you tell me the other name of pituitary?
Master gland.
Master of master gland.
Pituitary gland is also called as hypophysis. Okay.
Neurohypophysis.
Anterior pituitary and posterior pituitary, and that is referred as adenohypophysis and neurohypophysis.
And neuro.
Okay. So, yeah, neurohypophysis, that is posterior pituitary. Which are the hormones secreted by posterior pituitary?
Oxytocin and prolactin.
That's good. That is oxytocin and vasopressin, ADH.
Vasopressin.
Yeah, that is created by the posterior pituitary. In fact, what happens, the posterior pituitary hormones, they are in true sense not hormones because they are not released from posterior pituitary.
Yes, sir, it is all.
Yeah. They are synthesized.
Yes, in the
nerve tracts connecting hypothalamus and pituitary, posterior pituitary, they remain stored over there, and as and when stimulus comes, they are released. Right? So,
yes.
The
posterior pituitary are referred as neurohormones. Hormones which are regulated by the neural control are called as neurohormones. Example is ADH and oxytocin. Clear? Next we come to is neurohumerals. Neurohumerals are the secretions released at nerve terminals. You know epinephrine, norepinephrine, acetylcholine. These are the neurotransmitters which are released at nerve terminals, and they are referred as neurohumerals. So they are, that is the, you may get confused with neurohormones and neurohumerals. So make it absolutely clear in your mind that neurohumerals are the neurotransmitters. Okay? Neurohormones are the hormones of posterior pituitary. Then you will be able to explain it. Okay? Then we move to next. Yeah, we have two more terms. One is a parahormone, another is anti-hormone. So till now we have studied hormone, neurohumeral, and now it is a parahormone and anti-hormone. Before discussing parahormones, you must keep it in mind that while defining the hormone, I had told you that it is produced from specific site and acts at specific site.
Specific.
Okay, but if you see the example of parahormones like CO2, histamine, prostaglandin, that most of the tissues of the body produces prostaglandin. Similarly, any inflammatory tissue produces histamine. All the metabolic cells produces CO2. So, how we'll define that parahormones are the chemical messengers or regulators which are not hormones in true sense. Means they are produced and acts of on multiple site. इनका जो साइट ऑफ प्रोडक्शन एंड साइट ऑफ एक्शन मोर देन वन होता है. क्लियर?
यस सर.
फाइन. नेक्स्ट वी कम टू इज एंटी हार्मोन्स. वेल व्हाइल डिस्कसिंग द एंटी हार्मोन्स यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड ऑफ एंटीबॉडीज.
यस यस सर.
एंटीबॉडीज क्या होती हैं? रुखसार बताएगी. यस
सर. एंटीबॉडीज वही होते हैं जो भी बैक्टीरिया या जो वायरस होता है उससे
या
से मतलब बचाव करते हैं.
नहीं बेटे, कैसे प्रोड्यूस होते हैं बॉडी में आपके? हाउ दे आर प्रोड्यूस्ड इन योर बॉडी सिस्टम?
सर एंटीबॉडीज तो
या
इंजेक्शन के द्वारा वगैरह हार्मोन्स के.
नहीं नहीं, देखिए से आप लोग को फीवर होता है. मान लीजिए कभी किसी को फीवर होता है. फीवर इज ड्यू टू सम इन्फेक्शन, मे बी बैक्टीरियल और सम वायरल इन्फेक्शन. ओके, देन व्हाटएवर द इन्फेक्टेड ऑर्गेनिज्म बॉडी में जाते हैं उसके अगेंस्ट एंटीबॉडीज प्रोड्यूस होनी शुरू हो जाती हैं, ताकि उस इन्फेक्शन को दे कैन गेट रिड ऑफ फ्रॉम द बॉडी सिस्टम. इजंट इट? सो anti hormones are substances which are produced within the body in response to hormones being injected in the body system. What happens, we have domesticated the animals. theek hai, humne animals ko to domesticate kar liya, parantu kya hai ki unki productivity and reproduction ko further increase karne ke liye we are using hormonal preparations or hormones for bringing the animals into estrus or cause super ovulation. So when the hormones are injected, since these are the mostly peptide in nature, there is production of antibody against these hormones. That is called as anti-hormones. Not antibodies, but they'll be referred as anti-hormones. So whenever we are using these hormonal injections into the animals, they lead to production of anti hormones. And it is always advisable that when you have to go for hormonal therapy, sufficient interval time gap should be given. Otherwise, what will happen, that if you are repeatedly giving hormones into the animal, the antibody level will increase to a level that when you inject the hormone subsequently would neutralize ho jayega aur us hormone ka animal pe koi effect nahi aayega. Clear?
Yes sir, should be.
Okay. Yes, sir. Fine. So next I'll come to is, yeah, so this was all about the various hormones. Now all these hormones are regulated in our body system in four ways. That is autocrine regulation, paracrine regulation, neurocrine regulation, and solocrine regulation. So first of all, what is autocrine regulation? In autocrine regulation, what happens? The hormones are secreted, and after secretion from the ductless gland, they get into the extracellular space. Okay, they get into the extracellular space, but at the same time they return back to that very cells and regulate its release. आप आगे जब पढ़ेंगे तो उसमें आता है कि हार्मोन कंसेंट्रेशन इज ए मेजर फैक्टर विच रेगुलेट्स इट्स सेक्रेशन. तो अगर जैसे हार्मोन रिलीज हुआ और वापस उसी सेल में आ गया तो उसकी कंसेंट्रेशन बढ़ जाएगी और फर्दर प्रोडक्शन स्टॉप हो जाएगी. क्लियर?
यस सर.
सो इन ऑटोक्राइन रेगुलेशन, व्हेनेवर द हार्मोन्स आर सेक्रेटेड, दे आर सेक्रेटेड लोकली, गेट इनटू द एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर स्पेस, एंड फ्रॉम द एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर स्पेस दे गेट बैक टू द सेम सेल्स, एंड दैट्स हाउ दे रेगुलेट इट्स, दे फर्दर दे विल स्टॉप फर्दर प्रोडक्शन. That is called as autocrine regulation. Next is paracrine regulation. It involves secretion of hormones from the cells directly into the extracellular space, and thereafter it regulates the hormones from in the adjacent cells. In simple language, मैं आपको समझाता हूँ कि जैसे ही hormones secrete होगा, again it will go into the extracellular space, और वहाँ extracellular space से they will be transported to another cell. ये देख, just see here surrounding extracellular spaces and hormones interact with the adjacent or nearby cells without being transported into the blood. ये blood में नहीं जाते हैं. Simply first case में था कि extracellular space में आए, वहां से वापस उसी cell को regulate किया. ये extracellular space में आके they will regulate the adjacent cells. Got it? Rohit?
Yes, sir. कोई example से अगर explain है तो.
I'll be we'll be taking up all these examples later on. अभी आप एक principle समझ लीजिए, क्योंकि अभी कई चीजें हैं, chemical nature of hormones and how they are mechanism of their regulation of secretion. वो आपको थोड़ा सा समझ आ जाएगा, फिर ये चीजें हम दोबारा ले लेंगे. अब तब ये concept आपको ज़्यादा better clear होगा. अभी तो एक थोड़ा सा just from the term, yeah. From the term.
Extracellular space में आने के लिए तो.
Okay. But when the hormone is released, the cells releases into the adjacent spaces. Blood circulation में नहीं आते हैं. And thereafter.
Extracellular space में आने के लिए भी blood circulation.
Got it. आपने ये जो what you are not getting into because you are keeping the definition of hormone in your mind. अब हम इन terminology को understand करने के लिए आप neurohumerals पे आएंगे. ठीक है? Neurohumerals they are neurotransmitters. They are released at nerve junctions. Acetylcholine, epinephrine, norepinephrine. वहां पर रिलीज होते हैं और एडजेसेंट सेल्स में डिफ्यूज हो जाते हैं एंड देयर दे शो इट्स एक्शन. क्लियर?
यस.
ओके, देन वी कम टू न्यूरोक्राइन सेक्रेशंस. इट इन्वॉल्व्स सेक्रेशंस ऑफ पेप्टाइड और अदर न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर मॉलिक्यूल्स बाय द न्यूरॉन्स. इट इज स्पेशलाइज्ड फॉर्म ऑफ पैराक्राइन सेक्रेशन वेयर द केमिकल मैसेंजर इज डिलीवर्ड बाय सिनैप्स और न्यूरोमस्कुलर जंक्शन. You have already studied the nervous system, where we studied that the place where more than one nerves joins together is referred as neuromuscular junction or synapse. So it is again is just similar to paracrine secretions, that they are released, diffuses in the adjacent cells and acts as a chemical messenger to regulate the neural activity, that the nerves in adjacent to that will be stimulated or inhibited accordingly. जैसा हार्मोन का नेचर होगा उसी हिसाब से उसको एक्टिवेट और इनहिबिट करेगा न्यूरोट्रांसमीटर. या बेटर यू टर्म न्यूरोह्यूमरल अगर आप दिमाग में रखेंगे तो ये आपको दोनों ज्यादा क्लियरली समझ आ जाएगा. फाइनली कमिंग टू दिस सोलोक्राइन रेगुलेशन, द हार्मोन्स आर सेक्रेटेड डायरेक्टली इनटू द ल्यूमन ऑफ द GIT, respiratory or reproductive tract. Ye, these secretions directly go into the these organ systems and there they show its activity. So these are, I'll be taking up this terminology once again when we have studied. There's a very important topic, how the hormones are regulated, that we may not be able to take up today. We'll discuss today or tomorrow, and thereafter we'll talk another. नेक्स्ट, अब सबसे इंपॉर्टेंट चीज आती है कि अभी तक आई थिंक आपको थोड़ा थोड़ा समझ आने लगा होगा कि एंडोक्राइनोलॉजी क्या चीज है. समझ आ रहा है? नाउ हाउ वी कैन स्टडी द एंडोक्राइनोलॉजी. से अगर आप ब्लड ग्लूकोज का इफेक्ट देखना चाहते हैं कि बॉडी में क्या है, व्हाट वी डू
ब्लड ग्लूकोज ब्लड कलेक्ट
करके उसकी कंसंट्रेशन फाइंड आउट करते हैं देन वी कैन से कि ग्लूकोज इज हाई और लो एंड अकॉर्डिंगली इट वी कैन स्टडी इट्स इफेक्ट. ठीक है. क्वेश्चन कम्स कि आप हाउ विल स्टडी द एंडोक्राइनोलॉजी. देर आर फोर मेथड्स बाय विच वी कैन स्टडी द एंडोक्राइनोलॉजी. उसमें सबसे लेटेस्ट एंड मोस्ट मॉडर्न मेथड है RIA और ELISA. RIA is radioimmunoassay, ELISA is enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. Radioimmunoassay or enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. ये दोनों tests हैं that helps to find out the concentration of hormones in the body. You must have heard of the goiter. Goiter सुना है?
What
happens in hypothyroidism? There is decreased production of thyroid hormones. परंतु क्या होता है कि hormone production तो कम होती है but the cells go on multiplying, उनकी hypertrophy हो जाती है due to hyperfunctioning. They try to much more accumulate the iodine and go for hyperfunctioning. So that's how the gland increases, thyroid gland increases in the size, body size. अगर आप say there is कोई doubtful case है कि hypothyroidism का case है कि hyperthyroidism, how we'll find out? We can find out by these two methods by trying to नो कि T3, T4 और TSH की कंसेंट्रेशन क्या है. सो ओके सो दैट इज द मोस्ट मॉडर्न एंड लेटेस्ट मेथड. दैट्स व्हाई आई टुक इट फर्स्ट. बट पुराने टाइम में जब ये मेथड्स नहीं होते थे, ये बहुत ज्यादा नहीं 50-60 साल पुराने मेथड्स हैं RIA और ELISA. उससे पहले क्या होता था, कैसे स्टडी करते थे डिफरेंट ग्लैंड्स एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड्स का इफेक्ट. वेल वन वाज बाय सर्जिकल रिमूवल ऑफ द ग्लैंड, also called as ablation of the gland, ablation method. In this method, what we do, agar aapko jaise, agar hum pituitary ko remove kar dete hain, ya thyroid ko remove kar dete hain, or much easier, testes remove kar dete hain, theek hai, in a male animal or male bird, if testes is removed, whatever the effects coming on into the on the animal body system, that is attributed to the substances produced by the testes. ये तो आज हमें पता है ना कि वहाँ से testosterone निकलता है, but पुराने time में ये नहीं पता था कि testosterone निकलता है. So by that method, that was the easiest and simplest method to remove the gland, which is not possible in the human beings. Experimental animals में आप कर सकते हैं, that too with great difficulty. But that was the method followed in earlier times to remove the gland and study the various changes in that animal. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Second yes, method sir. आता है कि again उसी का alternative कि अगर आप अब जैसे pancreas है, आप pancreas को हटा तो नहीं सकते, अंदर आपको deep rooted operate करना पड़ेगा, then you can remove the pancreas. But there must be some method by which must be some chemicals which we can destroy the gland. Okay? So biochemical destruction of the glands, there by use of certain chemicals, certain cells are destroyed in the animal body system. And again, फिर उसके बाद जो effect आता है body पे, वो आप देख सकते हैं, that can be attributed to that particular gland. थर्ड मेथड है बायोएसे और एडिटिव इफेक्ट. बायोएसे क्या होता है कि अगेन कि जैसे आपने कोई एनिमल बॉडी का ग्लैंड निकाल लिया एनिमल से और उसका एक आपने मिक्सचर सॉल्यूशन ट्रैचुरेट करके सॉल्यूशन बना लिया एंड दैट सॉल्यूशन इज एडेड टू अनदर एनिमल, इंजेक्टेड इनटू अनदर एनिमल वेयर it will start showing some additional effect rather than the normal body effect. So say additionally it will show some effects. So that you can study, attribute that those effects are due to the that particular gland. Say a common study hui hai about the thyroid gland. Ki jaise koi dead animals hai ya animals which have just died, there you can remove the thyroid gland, make a solution or triturated mixture of thyroid gland and inject into another animal. Thereafter, whatever the effects, people recorded increase in BMR, increase in milk production, like that. So those effects are attributed to the hormones of thyroid gland. Samajh gaye? So, yes, so these are the how we study, we can study the four endocrinology or secretions of the hormones by various endocrine glands using these four methods. RIELA is already explained to you. Yeah, this is a very important thing. Hypothalamo hypophyseal portal system. Ye mere ko thoda sa slide pehle lena chahiye tha. Anyway, how this operate? Abhi aap hypophysis aur pituitary hai. Theek hai? Aap kya bol rahe the? This is the master endocrine gland of the body?
Yes.
So hypophysis is a master endocrine gland of the body.
Yes, sir.
No. It used to be. किसी समय hypophysis or adrenal pituitary gland को was referred as master endocrine gland of the body. But after the discovery of releasing hormones or releasing factors, you can see there are so many releasing hormones and inhibitory hormones. These hormones, releasing hormones, are secreted by the hypothalamus into the portal system, and through the portal system they are carried to hypophysis, and in response to that hypophysis releases these hormones. So now which one is the master endocrine gland?
Hypothalamus.
Yes, so hypothalamus is the master endocrine gland of the body system. And so just try to understand two important things before I start discussing about the releasing hormones and all, that hypothalamus is a center of the body which, besides releasing various releasing hormones, it has nuclei for releasing so many regulating so many functions of the body that you have already studied in the nervous system. Theek hai?
Yes sir,
wo padh chuke hain hum. अब इसका ये जो पोर्टल सिस्टम का क्या रोल आ रहा है, ये अगर हाइपोथैलेमस इन रिलीजिंग हार्मोन्स को सीधे सर्कुलेशन में डाल देता और सर्कुलेशन से ये हाइपोथाइसिस में आ जाते, देयर दैट दे कुड हैव शॉर्ट इफेक्ट. व्हाई दिस पोर्टल सिस्टम? एनीबॉडी? पहले तो ये बताइए. हाँ पीयूष, यू वांट टू स्पीक? You want to speak something? Durga?
There must be some ion exchange.
No. Anji, or who will like to answer this question? Okay, before taking up that question, I'll explain one thing. What is portal system? You must have heard of hepatic portal system?
Yes, sir.
Just now I'm not going to talk about hepatic portal system. I am going to talk about hypothalamo-hypophyseal portal system. Hypothalamo-hypophyseal portal system में क्या होता है? एक blood vessels का एक network होता है, जो hypothalamus से सीधे connect होता है hypophysis में, rather than going into the general circulation. So that secretions of hypothalamus directly reaches hypophysis rather than going into general circulation, thereafter reaching the hypophysis. Clear?
Yes sir.
किसको समझ आ गया? आप बताइए, अगला क्वेश्चन मेरा फिर आएगा.
तो स्पेसिफिक पाथवे प्रोवाइड करने के लिए ये मतलब पोर्टल सिस्टम, जैसे कि डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम में भी इंटेस्टाइन टू लीवर मतलब डायरेक्ट हार्ट के जगह मतलब उसी के बेसिस पे सर इसलिए पोर्टल सिस्टम है, मतलब एक अल्टरनेट पाथवे डिफाइन करने के लिए.
Okay, Rohit has you have said that there is a definite pathway that excretes from hypothalamus goes to hypophysis. But its advantage kya hai? Ek to theek hai, aapne portion bata diya. What is the advantage of this?
Basically, sir, it regulates.
Tell you, I'll tell.
So it need to store, sir, hormone storage, sir.
No. These hormones are not stored. What happens? These releasing hormones, अगर ये hypothalamus से secrete होके general circulation में चले जाते, तो by the time they had reached the hypophysis, their concentration would have decreased. So more quantity of releasing hormones, releasing factors would have been required to stimulate hypophysis. Here, since they are being transmitted from hypothalamus directly to the hypophysis, so even a small quantity of releasing hormone is good enough to stimulate the hypophysis. Clear?
Yes, sir.
One thing more. Never get confused about releasing hormones and releasing factors. They are the same. Releasing hormone and releasing factors. ठीक है? Yeah, both are the same things. Now I'll come to how, what are the, which are ones are the releasing hormones. First releasing hormone to be identified was corticotropin releasing hormone, CRH. First releasing hormone to be identified was CRH, corticotropin releasing hormone, or many times we called as adrenocorticotropic releasing hormone. Clear? Second one is STH, somatotropic releasing hormone, or it is also referred as growth hormone, GH. G for growth, H for hormone. So somatotropic releasing hormone, somatotropic inhibitory hormones. We have two inhibitory hormones besides releasing hormones. One is for somatotropic, other is for prolactin inhibitory hormone. This is prolactin releasing hormone, and this one is prolactin inhibitory hormone. Then this one is Rohit, ye kya hai? You can see my cursor.
Thyroid
gonadotropin.
Yeah, GnRH. It is gonadotropic releasing hormone. Then this is okay. Yeah, this one TRH, that is thyrotropin releasing hormone, or TSHRH, thyroid
stimulating
hormone, releasing hormone. TSH will be released by hypophysis, pituitary. So here TSHRH or TRH. So which are the, how many releasing hormones? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Five releasing hormones and two inhibitory hormones. Inhibitory hormones are
prolactin inhibitory and
somatotropic inhibiting hormones.
Good. Yeah, one thing more. From the second name se clear lagta hai ki releasing hormones hai. They stimulate the release of hormones from hypophysis. और इनहिबिटरी क्या है? अगर इनहिबिटरी हाइपोथैलेमस से रिलीज हुआ है तो वो इनहिबिट कर देगा पर्टिकुलर हार्मोन का सेक्रेशन फ्रॉम हाइपोफाइसिस. क्लियर?
यस सर.
बट देयर इज वन एक्सेप्शन. एक्सेप्शन क्या है कि प्रोलैक्टिन रिलीजिंग हार्मोन एंड प्रोलैक्टिन इनहिबिटरी हार्मोन्स, इसमें से प्रोलैक्टिन इनहिबिटरी हार्मोन इज इनफैक्ट regulates the release of prolactin from the pituitary. ये यहाँ से जो release regulate करता है prolactin का hypophysis से, वो prolactin inhibitory hormone है rather than releasing hormone. Because ये hormones है feedback mechanism में regulate होते हैं, that I'm coming. So इसका एक ये exception है prolactin का. Rest are true to their name. If they are releasing hormone, they will cause the release. If they are inhibitory, they will cause inhibition of that hormone. So you are clear with the releasing hormones?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Total. Next, we come to pituitary. As any of these hormones, इनका एक ना mechanism होता है. अभी हम पढ़ेंगे कि feedback mechanism. अब जैसे ये आप TSH, you must have heard of thyroid stimulating hormone. इसका आगे क्या action होगा?
Thyroid gland पे act करेगा और thyroid release करेगा.
Thyroid
stimulate करेगा तो thyroid.
Got it.
Thyroid oxygen release करने के लिए
stimulate
करेगा वो
thyroid hormone.
Okay, मैं अब एक को example देता हूँ कि जो feedback mechanism कैसे release चलता है. मान लीजिए जो T3 लेवल है एनिमल बॉडी में इंक्रीज हो गया है, ठीक है, द लेवल ऑफ T3 हैज इंक्रीज्ड, सो इट विल गिव ए नेगेटिव फीडबैक. एक यहां पे नेगेटिव फीडबैक आएगा हाइपोथैलेमस. क्लियर? सो दिस नेगेटिव फीडबैक विल स्टॉप द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ TSHRH. Then, since the TSHRH production बंद हो गई है, so further TSH production बंद हो जाएगी. Getting it?
Yes, sir.
And since the TSH production has stopped, so thyroid gland पे further action for the production of T3, T4 will stop. So the T3, T4 level will come to normal. और जैसे ही T3 T4 लेवल डाउन जाएंगे, अगेन ए स्टिमुलस विल गो फॉर रिलीजिंग द TSHRH फ्रॉम द हाइपोथैलेमस. यहां पे नेगेटिव की बजाय ये पॉजिटिव फीडबैक आएगा फ्रॉम थायराइड ग्लैंड. कुछ समझ आया ब्रीफली अबाउट द फीडबैक?
यस सर. कंसंट्रेशन खुद ही
उस पे आते हैं बेटे. कंसेंट्रेशन पे आई एम कमिंग, बट आप बेसिक मैकेनिज्म थोड़ा सा समझ लीजिए कि जो भी हार्मोन्स आपके बॉडी सिस्टम में जैसे ही उनका नॉर्मल से लेवल डाउन होता है, वो एक सिग्नल देते हैं हाइपोथैलेमस को. इन अबाउट आई एम टॉकिंग ऑफ ऑल दीज हार्मोन्स. सो हाइपोथैलेमस को सिग्नल आया, हाइपोथैलेमस स्टार्ट रिलीजिंग दीज रिलीजिंग हार्मोन्स और रिलीजिंग फैक्टर्स. दे एक्ट ऑन द हाइपोफाइसिस टू कॉज द रिलीज ऑफ दीज hormones and they act on their body system, gland to further increase the production of the hormone like FSH. FSH name is follicle stimulating hormone. So when this FSH is released, it acts on the ovary to cause follicle stimulation, and that's how it shows its effect. And luteinizing hormone in females, it plays the role as for ovulation, and whereas in males it plays a different role in production of gamete. So that we'll be taking up one by one later. So I think by now you are clear with कि हाइपोथैलेमस का क्या रोल है, हाइपोफाइसिस का क्या रोल है, एंड दीज रिलीजिंग हार्मोन्स, इनहिबिटरी हार्मोन्स, व्हाट एक्शन दे प्ले. क्लियर?
यस सर.
ओके, सो नाउ आई कम टू नेक्स्ट. जो अभी आप बात कर रहे थे ना कंसंट्रेशन की, सो हाउ दीज हार्मोन सेक्रीशंस आर रेगुलेटेड. First is, there are three mechanisms by which these are regulated. Take a minute. Okay. So there are three mechanisms by which the hormone regulation in the animal body system takes place. First is humoral regulation. Humoral means hormone ka role hota hai. Nervous regulation, I need not tell you. And third is genetic one. So I'll talk first about the genetic one. The genetic regulation hai, it takes a longer time. Kai generations ke baad uska impact aata hai. Whatever the changes going on in the animal body system, many times leads to increased production of a particular hormone or decreased production of particular hormone, and that's how they develop the tolerance or enhance or reduce the functions, particular function in the animal body system. But that will take place over a period of generations. Whereas humoral and nervous regulation is in routine. Minute to minute, second to second regulation is governed by humoral and nervous regulation. Take you to one. First is concentration of a metabolite. Concentration of metabolite, aap dekh rahe hain. Can anybody give me an example? Okay. Yeah, we were here. Can anybody give me an example that how the concentration of a metabolite regulates the hormone secretion?
Agar blood glucose level blood mein increase kar jata hai, to phir insulin sir cellular uptake utilization ko promote karta hai.
Okay. That's a very good answer. Very excellent. मेटाबोलाइट के हमारे बॉडी में डिफरेंट मेटाबोलाइट्स होते हैं वो हार्मोन रेगुलेट कैसे करते हैं रोहित आई थिंक गिव अ वेरी गुड आंसर कि से आपकी बॉडी में अगर ग्लूकोज कंसंट्रेशन बढ़ गया है मींस ग्लूकोज अपटेक इज नॉट टेकिंग प्लेस कंसंट्रेशन हैज इंक्रीज्ड सो इट गिव्स ए पॉजिटिव फीडबैक टू द पैंक्रियास टू रिलीज इंसुलिन सो इंसुलिन इज रिलीज्ड एंड देयर आफ्टर देयर विल बी utilization of glucose. As soon as glucose normal comes down, it normalizes, and later on it will start declining. As soon as it starts declining, it gives another negative feedback. Negative feedback jayega. So negative feedback will stop further production of insulin. So this is how the concentration of a metabolite regulates the hormone humoral regulation in the animal body system. Then coming to the concentration of other hormone. Yes? Anybody else amongst the girls? How the concentration of other hormones regulates the hormone secretion? Yeah, anybody?
Sir, sure nahi hai sir, galat bhi ho sakta hai.
Bataiye, no problem, bataiye.
सर कैल्सिटोनिन सर हाइपोकैल्सेमिक है तो फिर ब्लड स्ट्रीम में अगर कैल्शियम लेवल डिक्रीज कर जाता है तो पैराथॉर्मोन हार्मोन
बट बेटा कैल्शियम इज नॉट ए कैल्शियम इज अ मेटाबोलाइट नॉट ए हार्मोन हार्मोन टू हार्मोन
थायराइड ग्लैंड से
बेटे ये क्या बताया था आपको
नेगेटिव फीडबैक एंड पॉजिटिव फीडबैक ऑफ
हां
यस सर नेगेटिव फीडबैक मैकेनिज्म
यार जो भी है हार्मोन्स अब जैसे मैंने आपको टीएसएच का एग्जांपल दिया था ठीक है आई हैड गिवन यू द एग्जांपल ऑफ टीएसएच टीएसएच एक्टिंग ऑन द थायराइड टू प्रोड्यूस टी3 एंड टी4 ठीक है जस्ट अ सेकंड इट प्रोड्यूसेस T3 and T4. So, sorry. Again, TSH causing production of T3, T4. ठीक है, जैसे ही T3, T4 level body में high जाएगा, increase हो जाएगा, it will give a negative feedback to the hypothalamus. So there will be no more production of TSHRH. ठीक है, so the TSHRH production stops, no more production of
TSH.
So the hormone production of T3, T4 will also stop. And that is how the hormone, one hormone is regulating the concentration of another. TSH is a hormone, TSHRH is a hormone, T3, T4 is a hormone. So one hormone is regulating the concentration of another. Clear?
Yes, sir.
I think this is the easiest example, yes, and simplest example to understand. Yeah, next we come to is nervous regulation. It's very simple. Again, hypothalamic connection and peripheral nerve connection. Discussing autonomic nervous system, I had told you about the preganglionic secretions and postganglionic secretions, isn't it?
So,
वहाँ पे इनका जो main important role आ जाता है कि peripheral nerve connections, how they come into. I'll just share one more page. There, that will help you to understand the things. Yeah, here you can see peripheral nervous control of hormones. Peripheral, I'll just read, then I'll explain you. Peripheral nervous control of hormones output is difficult to separate entirely except in case of adrenal medulla, where the peripheral nerve connections, preganglionic sympathetic fibers, can cause increased output of epinephrine. This impulse is due to the result of frightful image on the visual cortex. Another method involves the hypothalamic connections that is mediated through nervous control. This may just, I'll explain you in a very simple language. I had given you one assignment last time, I think. How many of you have worked on that? रोहित क्या असाइनमेंट था?
फाइट और फ्लाइट रिस्पांस पे एक पेज का नोट लिखना।
राइट, सो यू कैन मेल मी दैट नोट। यू मेल डॉक्टर प्रमोद एंड देन आई विल डिस्कस विद हिम। ओके, हम उसी टॉपिक पे वापस जाना चाहते हैं कि जैसे क्या होता है पेरिफेरल नर्व कनेक्शंस कैसे हार्मोन कंट्रोल करते हैं। आप रास्ते में जा रहे हैं, व्हाट हैपेंस, आई हैव टोल्ड यू ऑन दैट डे, आप जा रहे हैं, ऑल ऑफ अ सडन ए स्नेक अपीयर्स, व्हाट हैपेंस, योर हार्ट रेट इंक्रीजेस,
yes,
heart rate, yes, increases, sir. Respiration rate increases. What is the reason for increase in the heart rate and rate of respiration?
So adrenal gland releases epinephrine
hormone, adrenaline hormone.
ठीक है, अब समझ आ गया कि nerves और hormones कैसे आपस में interact करते हैं, क्योंकि आपका जो visual signals हैं, eyes ने catch किया कि there is a snake, that was conveyed to a higher center and through that hormones were released from the glands. That is how the peripheral nervous control takes place. And about the hypothalamic regulation as a second point, hypothalamic mein kya hota hai, there are two things. First is of course the release of various releasing hormones, releasing factors, but another important thing is effect of light is a very important one. That आपने सुना होगा कि पोल्ट्री फार्म्स में हम रात को भी लाइट जला के रखते हैं, सुना है?
Yes, sir.
We give extra daylight to the birds. Why?
उसके ग्रोथ के लिए,
Yeah, I like to take Sneha will answer this question. हाँ जी चलिए स्नेहा बताइए not able to answer anybody else okay what happens these extra light hours through hypothalamus causes stimulation of hypothalamus and various glands releases melatonin आप melatonin secretion सुना है पहले
Yes, sir. That
also regulates the production and reproduction, and that is how the egg production increases due to extra daylight. Okay. So that is how the hypothalamic connection plays the role, or nervous ये role play करते हैं. So this is how it happens. About genetic regulation, I have already told you, and so this is how the regulation takes place. I'll again come back to PPT. So this is how the regulation of hormone secretion feedback takes place. Agar itna portion, I'll just stop over here for the day. Wherever any point is not clear, you can pass on to Dr. Pramod. He'll pass on to me. And tomorrow before going ahead, I'll take up those points, then I'll move ahead. And the topics which are going to discuss tomorrow, you can just have a look at it, then that you can go through in the books. First is interrelationship of endocrine and nervous system, how they are interrelated, chemical nature of hormones, okay, hormone transport. And चलिए ये आपका जो next assignment था that is for tomorrow that I'll assign you tomorrow we'll add something more to this then we'll okay before I bind up any queries very disgusting only 14 part students are attending the class आप सभी स्टूडेंट्स से मेरा एक कही है कि आप अपने अपने फ्रेंड्स को बोलिए दे मस्ट ज्वाइन इट बाय टुमारो अदरवाइज आपको ठीक है पूरी बुक आपके पास है यू कैन स्टडी इट फ्रॉम दैट ठीक है
यस
या एनीथिंग एल्स कोई क्वेरी आपकी कोई और कुछ Nothing. If there is not to discuss much, we'll again meet tomorrow, same time. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.